5 for the voting.
I shall be doing it from the place where I'm sitting. Shall I be talking about all the qualified speeches or just in the
qualified?
As the table topic speeches, you can give the time.
The timing, the people who have qualified for the table topic speech are Monica Bole. Time taken 1:28. Vikram Singh, time taken 1:29. Vivek Shivale, time taken 1:20. Santosh Suryavanshi, time taken 1:14. Shipra, time taken 1:06. And Kiran Khaire spoke for 52 seconds, so he's under time and disqualified.
You didn't just 8 seconds. One more bullet.
Thank you.
So, once you are done, heading towards the evaluation section. This is where the general evaluator, the speech evaluator and their team actually tear apart the speeches given today piece by piece, and they do it while trying to motivate the speakers and providing them tips on how they can improve as you show in the presentation. In order to start jumpstart the evaluation session, please help me once again welcome general evaluator Amol Mitre to start the evaluation session.
Thank you, Toastmaster. So as a general evaluator, I will call the first evaluator, that is me. Speaker delivered a story with title Beauty is Forever. Full marks for title selection. What helps to grab the attention of the audience? It's opening, right? He opened his speech in a way which grabbed the attention of each and everyone present here. It was powerful. It was very strong. The importance of opening is it makes your impression. First impression is last impression. So I always, as an evaluator, I always focus on the opening of the speech. Then if we see his, the body of the speech, he shared his personal story, a story of Abhisa. He explained how beautiful she was. The body was related to the title of the speech. We were able to relate what is going to say about Abhisa. So full marks for the body as well. The content of speech was very well arranged. It was precise. No jargons, simple, sweet words. The words which can explain the beauty of any girl in a better way. So full marks for the content selection as well. If we look at the objectives, the main purpose of this speech was to deliver your emotions. Do you feel this speech was emotional?
Yes.
It was so much emotional. He delivered it in an amazing way. The best part of his story was when he was explaining how he felt when she passed away. Right? Even I felt a little bit sad as an evaluator, as an audience. So full marks for that as well. But as we know, nobody is perfect in this world. There is always a scope of improvement for everyone. Few suggestions, sir. When you are acting, then don't look at the audience. When you are giving rose to Abisa, look at her, not at the audience. So it will add more effect on your story. First few minutes, almost 4 minutes 30 seconds, you were explaining about her beauty. You could have added few stories or few incidences. One more suggestion, the time is 6 to 8 minutes, but you ended your speech around at 6 minutes 30 seconds. Use 8 minutes completely, it's your time. So these are few suggestions you can note on me. As an evaluator, it's an honor for me to evaluate such a wonderful speaker. The message I can draw from this story is our outer beauty is temporary, but our inner beauty is permanent. So be beautiful from inside. All to you.
Okay, so that was a wonderful evaluation as well. So now I'd like to call up on the stage the second evaluator of the day, Viva Pandey. She will be evaluating the speech given by Toastmaster Sachin Nayak.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I'm here to evaluate Sachin's speech. Sachin's great job. Are you sure this was your CC1? Because it didn't look like it. It was good. It was perfectly well-structured speech. You are a true scorpion. I'm also a scorpion. So you actually showed me a mirror today. Thank you for that. You know, scorpions are good people. Yeah, you know, when I was in office, I didn't know that Sachin really existed. But then there was one function where I came to know that he is there, and from that day he really became visible. So scorpions are like that, you know. Coming back to the evaluation, I'll just read the points and I'll evaluate you on that, what my views are. The strong points that you had is you had a good content. You had good pinch of humor everywhere. Personally, I love storytelling, so you had stories everywhere. So I love that. How well did the audience get to know the speaker? They know you now. I think everyone knows. I think if you would have brought the tone here, they would know you. So that was that. Did the speech reflect adequate preparation? You were fully prepared. So that showed. Did the speaker talk clearly and audible? Your voice was very audible. Good voice fluctuation for them, so it was very clear. Does the speech have a definite opening, body, conclusion? I'll come to that in the next section. Speaker's use of notes, I think you did. You had certain things over here, but then it didn't look like you didn't use it. So, full points on that. How would the speaker have done differently? Okay, now I'm combining both of them over here. I think the start could have been a bit differently. Could have started with a story, because I love stories, you know. So I think if story would have been there, it would have been a very good one, but it was a good. And the satires, the jokes, I think if you can add a perfect timing to those, you know, you'll get there. So that's all. All in all, a good speech. Thank you.
Thank you, Viva, for the rapid fire evaluation. Suspecting that. Please let us know if you there as well. Okay, so now we move on to another exciting part, and this is the part where all of you will be judged. Like if you are really listening or sleeping during this whole thing. If you are really listening closely to all the speakers, and that will be done by our quiz master of the day, Toastmaster Soumya Jain.
To write down some questions. I'll start with the first question. In the story, there was a girl and there was sir. What was the age of the girl and the and sir?
girl's age was 19 and sir was getting 12.
Great. Okay, the second question is, where did the girl, Abisa, where did she work? Pooja?
Yeah, in his father's farm or
farm. Correct. Yeah. And the third question is, of which disease did Nabisa got? Correct. Okay, I'll move on to the second speaker, Sachin. And it was again a great speech. So, in Sachin's speech, first story which he told, which was about two fat people, which two animals did he told? the last. So, yeah.
Monkey and animal.
Multiple times repeat both I. That's where you can do one.
for our table topic master, Sarvesh Pole, you thrice used the word "a," and there was one noun box. For Monica, was again you used the word "a" as thrice, and there was a repetition of word "so" twice, and there was one fumble. For Vikram, it was you used the word "a" four times in your speech, and there was one duplication of the word. I really don't remember the word, but it was you repeated it multiple times. For Kiran, so whatever time you spoke up, you didn't use any "a." It was all a long pause. It was all a long pause. For Vivek Shivale, he's the man who loves using "you know." He used it six times during his speech. And that's it. For Santosh, it was four times he used the word "a." For Shipra, it was very good. Like she improved from the last time. And she has used the word "a" only two times. There was one time where you duplicated the word. For Soumya, it was twice you used the word "a." And you used "so" multiple times when you were presenting. And there was two long pauses. That's it from my side.
Thank you. And I am imagining how you are actually evaluating yourself. I just said an okay, so without any further delay, let me go to the grammarian's report of the day. The grammarian today is Toastmaster Jayita Gupta.
I'll start with the prepared speeches. The first speech, as everybody noted, really flawless, but one sad part, it was there was no use of the word of the day or the idiom of the day. It was a very well said speech. Other than that, it was undoubtedly picturesque and very vivid. Second speech, Sachin Nayak. Again another near flawless speech. He used the word of the day once, and then there are just two observations. First is the Hindi title being used, Chupa Rustam, but yes, that is a title. And then he used a phrase called bulky body shape. So body, one type of body shape is bulky, so that was another. Bulky body shape is not required, so that was a wrong usage of grammar. Other than that, he had some overlapping sentences where one sentence would not be complete and the next sentence would start. Other than that, very vivid, very picturesque, and you were completely into the flow of your speech. Table topic master, our expert speaker, Sarvesh Khole, and I thank him for using the word of the day. Other than that, I have no observations. Very vivid as always. TMOD. he is a very vivid and enthusiastic speaker, but tiny grammatical errors like don't know nothing about, it should be don't know anything about. And then of course you were overlapping past and present tenses. Sometimes the first sentence was past tense and then you were immediately into the present tense. So that's all from my side. And Amol. Very strong speech, thanks for your presence here, but I observed one contradicting oxymoron, which is a strong weak point. So that was wrong grammar usage. Again, very vivid and very enthusiastic speech. Thanks for that. The table topic speakers, very interesting session. I'll start with Monica. It was a